good morning, good evening, good afternoon, good whatever time of day it is and whatever part of the world you're at right now. Welcome back. And today we're going to do an algebra review on solving and graphing inequalities in one variable. Okay? So let's go ahead and jump in. All right. So for the first one, number 43, we're still going to use our solving equations, rules, and properties to solve inequalities. So we're going to move the 13 to the other side by subtracting it. Now we're going to have 11x greater than or equal to negative 33. And the last step here is to divide both sides by 11. X is greater than or equal to negative 3. Now that we solved the answer, on our number line, the negative, we need to put a dot on negative 3. And it's going to be a closed circle because it's equal to, okay? And now we shade in the direction that the arrow says to shade. We're going to shade to the right. Everything is greater than. Anything greater than any number is always to the right of the number, okay? So, one more time. The symbol we have right here, that's going to be a closed circle. And we're going to be shaded to the right. Shade to the right. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look at number 44. We're going to move our variables to our left. And with solving inequalities, it's best if you always keep the variables on the left. Sometimes you may not, but for the most part, try to keep the variables on the left. So we're going to subtract 3x from both sides. That's going to give us negative 5x plus 6 greater than negative 34. Now we subtract 6 from both sides. That's going to give us negative 5x greater than negative 40. Now, our last step is to divide, and we're dividing by negative 5. Whenever you divide inequalities by a negative, the symbol has to change. So instead of the symbol saying greater than now, the symbol is going to be less than, because I divided by a negative number. And a negative divided by a negative is a positive, 40 divided by 5 is 8. So, the main thing that you need to remember is that when dividing by a negative, the symbol has to change. Now, according to our symbol, this is going to be an open circle on positive 8. And it's facing the left, so we're going to shade left. So, we do an open circle on positive 8. And now we shade the line all to the left, everything to the left. And if you notice, I always put an arrow on the end of my line because it keeps on going. All right. Number 45. Once again, when we go ahead and distribute, we're going to distribute. So that's going to give us 3x minus 7x minus 21 greater than or equal to negative 13. Combine our like terms, that gives us negative 4x minus 21 greater than or equal to negative 13. Add 21 to both sides. And when you do that, we end up with negative 4x greater than or equal to positive 8. Now, once again, we're getting ready to divide by a negative number. We're dividing by negative 4. So that means that our inequality symbol has to turn around. And 8 divided by negative 4 is negative 2. So now, our symbol should say, oops, sorry about that. Our symbol should say x is less than or equal to negative 2. And once again, because of our symbol, this is going to be a closed circle. It has the line underneath it. Whenever it's equals or included, it's a closed circle. So closed circle, sorry about that. And we're going to shade to the left. It's facing to the left. Shade left. And another way to remember how to shade it is to, if we zoom in, for example, the symbol says this right here. If you put an arrow, a line in the middle, it tells you which way to shade. Shade to the left. So we're going to have a closed circle on negative 2. Closed circle on negative 2. And we're going to shade everything to the left. And put an arrow on it. We're done. Number 46. For number 46, obviously, we're going to do the same thing. We have to distribute on the right side, so it's going to be 4 minus 8x on the left, less than 10 minus 6x on the right. We're going to add 6x to both sides because we want our variables on the left. That's going to give us 4 minus 2x less than 10. We're going to subtract 4 from both sides. That's going to give us negative 2x is less than positive 6. And we have to divide by a negative 2. And what happens when we divide inequalities by a negative? The symbol has to change around. So we get x is greater than negative 3. Because our symbol is a greater than, that means we're going to have an open circle. And which way do we shade? We shade to the right. So we're going to go to negative 3, put an open circle, and shade everything to the right. Make sure you put your arrow up. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that will conclude this video algebra review lesson for today. Deuces.